afternoon, good morning, good evening. This is Jenn Davida, your real estate solution, and I am just doing a quick, hey, this is what's going on in the market. It's Wednesday. This came in at like 5:30 in the morning, July 21st. So this is going to go out for the newsletter this Friday. And I love the information that we get from the Florida realtors. They are so amazing with their statistics, keeping us agents in the loop on everything. And of course we can feel it. We feel that there's something different going on in the market. We hear about it. We're looking on Zillow. We're seeing more listings, Redfin, realtor.com, so forth and so on. So I'm gonna include this article in which I printed these stats up and this information so you can read it for yourself. You can pass it along to somebody. If you have any family members that are looking to sell in Florida, or maybe they're looking to move to Florida, this information is going to affect either the buyer or seller differently, right? So right now, with the way things are, we have an increase of almost 20% of the median sales price, or the median value price for single family homes. It's now at $420,000, and that might seem low. Because for some folks, they might be purchasing at a higher price point, so that might seem low. But when we look at it overall for the entire state and we get this median range, it's actually quite significant. Not too long ago, this number was in the 200s. And for condos, it jumped up significantly as well. Just over 26%, and it's hovering around $325,000. We also, as you can see, we have lots more inventory out there. And so what does that mean? So for 2022 in June, the sales prices, or the number of sales, was down compared to last year, shocker, but they're actually not too far off from 2018 and 2019. So that, I mean, it's showing us where we had that, you know, that jump, right, with everything that was going on in the world, and now we're starting to see a settling, but we're only going back to kind of where we ended at 2018, 2019. However, interest rates are not going back to that. At least I don't see that happening. And so according to Freddie Mac, the interest rate for the 30-year fixed rate mortgage is averaging at 5.52%. That is significantly higher than the same month a year earlier. So for 2021, if you were purchasing a home and you had good credit and all those things were lining up for you, you were looking at a 2.98% interest rate. So what does that mean? For buyers, that means that you're going to be able to purchase a home with less stress. You'll have more options, so that's always cool. Get in touch with your favorite agent. If you don't have a favorite agent, please contact me. Get educated on what's going on. What does this mean to a seller? Well, this means that because the median price point has increased so significantly, you're still good. The entire line in the sand has been moved up in value for Florida. So you don't have to stress out that you're gonna lose out on so much. But we have to take the anomaly of last year and put things into perspective. But if you are concerned, or you're wondering where your value's at, or you just need guidance and, you know, consulting with a professional, by all means reach out to me and just brainstorm. And we can Zoom, we can talk, time is precious, so we can get a lot of information and we can get some plans going without having to meet. COVID did that, right? Zoom is so huge. So we can have a face-to-face consultation and just start planning. I think a good plan, a great plan, is really at the heart of the most successful transaction. So I hope you have a wonderful weekend. This is Jenn Davida. Please call me with any real estate questions or concerns, and have a blessed day.